Hello folks, welcome back to another video. It is Francesco here. Now, I thought today what I'd dive over is some of the Todoist updates, also some of the rumors, and just covering some of the things that you need to know about Todoist recently. I haven't covered it as much, but I thought it'd be cool to Friday, you know, give you a bit of sort of detail, something to focus on of what you can see in Todoist and also what's potentially coming up next. So let's dive into today's video. So folks, first I want to start with this new beta release, and if you're not already on the Todoist beta, I'll include some details below. Basically, this beta hasn't added massive amounts, but I think it's added some things that, with a few adjustments, can make your Todoist experience a lot better. So here I'm on the Mac version of the application, and as you see, it's slightly different. The left-hand panel is more to the left. The sort of today and sort of next 7 day area is much more central than before. And also it's a lot cleaner. Now, just to note, I am using this on a 16 inch screen. So as you can imagine, this new version is aimed to be designed better for wider screens, which hopefully should work for a lot of people with those screens that sort of look endless. So one of the major features is that this left-hand panel is now collapsible, and you can do that using the keyboard shortcut M. As you see, it sort of slides away really nicely, and that's something that I've actually been keen on having for a while, but didn't think I'd enjoy that much. I've been only using this beta for a day, but it's nice having that away from the central panel. And the main reason that I like that is because it reminds me of Things 3. Things 3 has such a nice sort of clutter-free experience. When you remove that, it can do wonders for focusing on the task at hand. Now, obviously, it is trying to increase the focus mode here. So as you can see, you can go and look at your tasks. There's a few minor issues, I think, with the way that the sort of project lands on the way that comments. But all you have to do to actually edit a task is press on it. And as you can see, it centralizes it. It doesn't put it to the right. I was always confused why they put it to the right. I got used to it. But this looks a lot better in the center because it's more of your channel, more of your focus. I would like to see this obviously adapted, but I think this is a much better way of viewing it. So that's one of the changes here. You can click off and it's fairly simple to do. I'm not really sure how valuable this edit button is. It's obviously to edit the title, but you can obviously edit the title inside of the article. So I'm not too sure how that's going to affect it. The one thing I did notice is there are some small and minor issues. Like, for example, if I go to Control and then click on a task and I go to move to project, as you can see, there's a bug that won't allow me to do that. However, if I do it currently on move to project here, it will appear. So that's only a minor issue. As you can see, if I tick something off, the other thing that comes up is the task completed. And I'm not sure why. I think maybe they're looking to sort of, you know, promote that sort of dopamine hit, like the completed task in front of you. But for me, I found that a little bit interruptive and annoying. The next thing that they've made a slight change on, I'm not sure whether it was there before, is this schedule button. So before, you can see this preview of like how many tasks you've got due, but you now see this like sort of dot underneath it to see whether there is a task on those days. And that's going to evolve. I'll talk about the new preview version near the end, but you can see that I've got no tasks on Thursday, so I could put this one on a Thursday. So as you can see, when you complete a task, the sort of completed area pops up, which is quite nice. So as you can see here, it's a really nice design, having everything clear and sort of, it's a bit more focused on, you don't have like this creeping in of like, okay, what have I got in my next 7 days? You can literally just go to today and see everything you need. There are some really minor bugs at the moment, but it's really something that I know that they'll fix in Todoist beta. One other micro thing is I'm not too sure about this search feature being still highlighted. I don't know whether I like it. I sort of like the entire distraction free experience, but again, it's really minor things and probably I'll change my mind as they improve. So you're probably wondering, like, what sort of updates are coming? And I've been on Twitter, obviously looking at Todoist and how they've done stuff. And as you can see, this latest tweet that they retweeted, that Henning, one of the Todoist front-end developers, and obviously Alex worked a lot on the design, and it was Stephen on the implementation, and he's the one who talked about the responsiveness for this. So that's a really nice update. The other thing that they have planned to release is currently in the beta is the newly designed Android widget. And apparently, as you can see via this preview, you can sort of like see a sort of outline of each of your tasks, and it could even be relevant to a certain list that you've got connected to. Amir actually posted about this, sharing a few of the integrations with the task view. So this is how it would look, say, on an Android device, but you also see that you can add in some details and also, you know, quick add from the widget, which is quite cool. So you don't actually have to leave the screen. So it's sort of like 3D touch abilities to some extent, and something that Todoist aim to add. So just going back to the other version, it looks like Alex was really fundamental on this release. And it's really, as I said, responsive designs for larger screen and a polish of the UI. So that's something that it looks a lot better on the 16-inch MacBook. I can definitely tell you that. So an update on boards. I saw that Nathan Littleton actually put any update on the boards, and that was early February. And they said there's no ETA on the boards. So we're still waiting around, I guess, which is a bit of a pain. Amir, according to Twitter, is also, they're looking to finalize the Twist 2.0 version, if that's something you're interested in, that they put on Twitter to make it a little bit easier. Now, if you haven't checked out this post as well, it's quite a good one. It's what's new in Todoist. It shares some of the sort of details of what they've added, like iOS 13 shortcuts, the dark mode. One thing that I noticed that I didn't actually have before was the multiple Google calendars. So you can actually associate two projects, multiple projects, into your calendar. So you can see that you can set that in the settings, and adding a calendar helps to make it you know, even easier to block timeout for a lot of people. You can also access the emails as, you know, add the emails as Gmail tasks, which is something that the Google Tasks is quite good at. So that's something that you can do on the web and the mobile version. They've made some changes to the Alexa edition. And also by default now, if you're in task view and you complete a task, it now appears down here as a completed subtask. And that's by default. I'm not sure whether you can modify that, but personally, I don't like it because I like to see everything clear. But at the same time, I know a lot of people like to see what they've done per project. There is also the Fantastical 3 update, which you can check out. Again, that's handy for those who are using that. You have to have premium just to remember that. And this is a sort of thing I wanted to talk about, is the next version. And they sort of deferred boards for a while. And I'm not sure why, but obviously they're focusing on this version next. And this version is essentially trying to put your calendar in front of your Todoist. I wouldn't say it's hideously improved, and that's me being honest. You can see here that the only thing they're really adding is this sort of preview window where you can see your next upcoming sort of month, I guess. So up, it might even be changed from next 7 days to upcoming. And in the upcoming view, if you tabbed this, it would open up the entirety of January, so you can click in and see. So I sort of like that, because that would help me to plan in advance more than, say, the next 14 to 21 days. But at the same time, it's not a major update that is going to sort of rock your entire use. I don't know yet, because they may allow you to just continually scroll, a bit like Inside of Things 3, where you can see the events and you continually see the plan. So that could be nice. I would be excited to actually see how that happens. But again, I'll let you know what my thoughts are. The other thing they said is they've updated the drop and drag, drag and drop design on iOS, allowing you to get a bit more of an indent and working out which is a subtask, which is a task, which is a section that you can create. So that's something that they're working on at the moment. So overall, I'm always impressed with what Todoist does. I would say they're not necessarily innovating massively, but they're building on their core experience. And what could come if they work on their core experience is some exciting views later on. Like in the next like year, it could be pretty exciting to see different ways that Todoist could be used. For example, a board view, some sort of notes view. I don't know anything more than you guys do, but obviously that's the way that I potentially see them growing and potentially see them catching up with other applications. And at the same time, being still relevant in the market. So guys, before I move on, Doist, the company behind Todoist, are sharing some great plans about how to go remote. I know a lot of people are having to work from home at the moment for obvious reasons. And they've got some remote guides here on the Twist plan. And obviously, you know, it's going to be different for every person, but there are some great guides on how to actually approach the situation. I have also got some videos here on YouTube about it, but at the same time, if you have any questions or you need any help, any guidance on tools that you need to choose for remote work, I'll put my email here so you guys can reach out to me, because obviously this sort of time is a bit stressful, especially if, well, one, you're working from home and you are totally new to it and you don't necessarily want to get like overwhelmed by the whole situation, and number two, if structurally or organizationally you need tools to help you align to work, then of course I'm happy to recommend project managers, to to-do list apps, to note-taking. But folks, I hope you enjoyed this video, and thank you very much for stopping by, and I'll talk to you all very soon. Cheers, everyone. Bye.